Y ya estamos en el día de la evaluación. Empecé todo mi proceso hace unos días. Ya me tocó entonces hoy ver al doctor Jeffrey para que nos explique qué es eso que nos vamos a estar haciendo. Y la evaluación, como siempre les digo, súper, súper importante, porque es donde vamos a descubrir qué nos hace falta, cuántas áreas del lipo nos vamos a hacer, por qué vamos a hacer la transferencia. Y el doctor además me va a estar explicando cuáles son los cuidados, qué hay que hacer después de la cirugía. Así que acompáñenme para que vean cómo es todo el proceso. Nos vamos a cambiar de ropa rapidito para que el doctor nos vea y ustedes me acompañen en todo el proceso. Así que vamos conmigo.
El primer paso, o sea, la evaluación para mi cirugía. Voy a hacer una lipo con transfer, o sea, liposucción con transferencia de grasa. En el día de hoy el doctor me va a evaluar personalmente. Esto también se puede hacer desde la casa, lo que pasa es que lo vamos a hacer acá hoy para que ustedes vean cómo es el proceso. Me va a examinar y me va a decir si soy candidata para la cirugía, qué me va a hacer. Yo le voy a explicar qué quiero y cuáles son mis expectativas, así que vamos a empezar.
Okay, so, you know, she's here today, she wants, you know, some liposuction. She wants to get the shape. She wants to add a little bit of some extra volume into her buttocks. She has had liposuction before, only on the stomach, so that from a surgical standpoint, you know, it's a little bit more difficult, because typically whenever you've had liposuction before, there's going to be a little bit more scar tissue. You know, in these cases, I always like to use the Vaser, which is an ultrasound-assisted liposuction. The Vaser shoots an ultrasound, so it helps to break up the fat and break up the scar tissue, so I can really create that fine line and that fine shape. So, you know, with any evaluation, you know, the main things that we're looking for, we're looking at the quality of the skin. She doesn't have any children. We're making sure there's no hernias there. We're making sure that there's enough fat. Let's take a look at the back. And she's not too big, but she's got, you know, some fat to do the operation. Okay. You know, she's a good candidate. She's a good candidate to really get sculpted. You know, with fat transfer, it's not an exact science. You know, what I tell people is that, you know, I need as much fat as possible because you're only gonna keep around 40% of the fat. What happens is when I take the fat from the abdomen at the back and I put it into her buttocks, what's gonna happen is your body needs to grow new blood vessels into that fat for the fat to survive. And that's not the easiest thing in the world. So, you know, typically I tell people you're gonna keep at best 40-50% of the fat that I put in there. So a little bit more is always a little bit better. You know, she has enough fat to do the operation. She's definitely on the skinnier side, so you know, you can't expect to be a gigantic result afterwards, but she doesn't want anyway. She just wants more of a form and a shape, which I think is something that we can you know, accomplish. You know, typically it's about an hour and a half operation. You know, after the operation, because of the transfer, no sitting for the first 10 days. I do use some drains. There's one drain in the abdomen, there's one drain in the back. The drains are gonna be there to get rid of fluid underneath the skin, so the skin sticks down faster, and it helps with the inflammation. They're gonna be there somewhere around the week. You're gonna wear the Baja, the garment, for 3 months. The first 2 months, all day, every day. The last month, half a day. Like I said, no sitting for the first 10 days. After 10 days, you can sit with a pillow underneath the thigh. Then after a month, you can sit and sleep normal. 2 months, still going back to the gym. Most people are back to work somewhere around a week or two.